Hi, I'm Jenny Yun. I'm so delighted to share some of César Franck's masterpieces to celebrate his bicentennial. They say Franck's organ works were the first major contribution to French organ literature in over a century, and most important organ music since Mendelssohn's. I'm going to open this concert with the first movement of one of his best-known organ works, Prelude, Fugue, and Variation, Opus 18, with violin piano version. In 1858, Franck became the organist at St. Clotilde. Shortly after, a magnificent symphonic cavaical organ was installed. He said, "If you only knew how I love this instrument. It is so supple beneath my fingers and so obedient to all my thoughts." Franck's trois is related to the Palace of Trocadero in Paris. Built during the World Exhibition in 1878, it was the first large organ concert hall in France. I'm going to play Fantasy in A and Cantabile from Trois Pièces. Fantasy in A is an epic. The journey starts with a bold unison followed by a delicate melody with tons of chromaticism. After this, the music takes us to a sanctuary, a place to lament. Some say it sounds like a sigh. Others say it reflects the composer's broken heart for the loss of others resulting from the Franco-Prussian War.
Thank you.
Now, we have a charming surprise. A collection of 59 small pieces from L'Organist for harmonium. Harmonium, also called reed organ, was way more popular and common then. It produces sound by foot-operated bellows. There are no pipes. Pitch is determined by the size of the reed. The titles such as offertory, communion, or socti suggest that it was probably written for church musicians for practical uses. He wrote this collection during the last years of his life. Variety of his lifelong compositional techniques are clearly displayed, namely melody and accompaniment, contrapuntal style, and choral writing. Very likely, they were written for teaching purposes as well.
Thank you.
last piece is the Sonata in A major for violin and piano. It is one of his best-known compositions and is considered one of the finest sonatas for violin and piano ever written. It was composed in 1886 as a wedding gift for a 28-year-old Belgian violinist, Eugène Seyer. The work is cyclic, which means all the movements share common thematic threads. We will play only the first and the last movement. First movement portrays the nervousness of meeting someone for the first time, expressed by a fluctuating theme. The fourth movement is a happy ending with the wedding bells and a festival of canonic exchange between violin and piano. An exuberant finale.
Thank you. Thank you.